next topic after complex number, related to complex number, that is quadratic equations. Now we are already aware of the quadratic equations. We have done in class 10th about the quadratic part, and one major concept in the quadratic part was about nature of the roots. Is it clear? You are knowing what basically the nature of the roots are. Now what we have done in class 10th, we have just written discriminant, that is D, is equal to B square minus 4AC, where A, B and C are the parts, are the coefficients for the quadratic equation. Okay, so we can write it AX square plus BX plus C is equal to 0, a quadratic equation. Now we have gone for the nature of the roots, and in the nature of the roots, we were having, if B square minus 4AC is greater than is equal to 0, we were having real roots, and these were also divided into two parts. If B square minus 4AC is greater than 0, then we were having real and unequal roots, but roots are 2 only. Why? Because degree is 2 here. And if B square minus 4AC was equal to 0, then 2 equal roots. Is it clear? Now, in our this session, in this class, we are going to do quadratic equation, but with the third nature. That was what? If, now we can write it, if B square minus 4AC is less than 0, then we are not going to write that no real roots. We will be writing, then we can have a complex roots. Just cancel. We can have complex roots, because now we are aware with the complex number. We are aware with the chapter for a complex number. Now, solutions of a quadratic equation in complex form will be, now in complex form what will be, earlier it was negative of B plus minus B square minus 4AC upon 2A will be equal to negative of B, or you can write it X is equal to, now this will be equal to negative of B plus minus 4AC minus B square with iota upon 2A. This is a complex form. Okay, when B square minus 4AC is less than 0, then we will be having which one? We will be having this part. These will be the roots. Okay, now one basic thing that was, according to fundamental theorem of algebra, and what is written, a polynomial equal, let it be of, equal of degree n has n roots. Is it clear? Now we have already gone through the complex cube root of unity in while doing the complex chapter. we have gone through a complex cube root of unity, and it was what? If the power of x, that was 3, we were having 3 answers, 1 real and 2 complex forms, 1 real, 2 imaginary, okay, 1 real, 2, total were 3. So now we are going to follow that part. A polynomial equal of degree n has n roots. Till class 10th, what you have done it? If we are having x cube in class 10th, suppose we were, it was x cube plus 1 is equal to 0, then what we were writing? We were writing x cube plus 1 is equal to 0, okay. So we were writing only one answer, okay. Or you can even write it x cube minus 1. You can write this also, x cube minus 1. So for x cube minus 1, we were, what we were having? We were having only one single root and we were not writing 2. But now you have to find the, whatever the degree is, that will be the roots. Is it clear? So we are going with the quadratic equations related with the complex number.